Hello everybody and welcome back to Vanilla Coast and City Skylines. We're today I had an well not today. Today, but yesterday. Oh gosh, my voice. Yesterday I had an epiphany, an amazing inspiration of how to get all of this a lot better. Let's put on fast mode because we want money. But the issue is it's going to require a redesign of a lot of the stuff. First of all, first we'll put the redesign into stuff that isn't built up yet. So, we need more roundabouts. And these roundabouts are going to have low traffic because they're going to service specific areas. And let me just show this as I build it out. Okay, so back it off one, back it off one. They were actually using that to get up here. Okay, so we are going to have one-way road. And I don't think this has to be big because, like I said, we're not going to have a ton of traffic here. So, oh, wait, that's right because... Ooh. You know what? Back that up. Because we are going to be having... Okay, right here. It needs to be... Oh, no. No. Because I want the circles to be even. So we need it out to there for it to be even. Otherwise, it's not going to be even. There to there to that did not turn out. Oh, because I messed that up. Okay, that was my fault. I saw what I did wrong. To there to there to there to there to there to there. Okay, we have a roundabout. The road in the middle is going to go bye-bye. But because of the tram, we do need something through there. Because we do want to keep this tram. Tram only. We're going to have it come out. Okay, we are going to make it out of normal road, I guess, first and foremost. To there, but the thing is that it's gonna be a little weird. A little bit of chicken fried, cold beer on a Friday night. Okay, 5, 6. Okay, it's 6 out, so 5, 6. To there, 5, 6, and to there. Because we're going to have an off-ramp right there, I believe. Right there? How did I plan this out? No. Okay. We had it as an X. To some degree. I'm trying to remember. I'm sorry, guys. I really am. Okay, the idea being is that we have two layers of highway underneath the road, right? This might actually be able to be connected in the future because we're going to have so much less traffic on this big circle that this big circle will actually be downgraded, kind of thing. Actually, these roads might actually be busier than this road after all is said and done. Okay, I need to just get to the point where I'm showing you guys what's going on. Let's back... that's gonna ruin me being able to put a straight... Well, no, because I can extend it off there, kind of. Let's back that off completely. We have markers to reconnect it. Oh yeah, I did do stuff too. Let me show you this. It looks kind of cool. It's an emblem underneath all of the stuff, but hiya. Looks cool, doesn't it? Anyways, let's get back to the work. No, not that. We want that to stay on that big. Actually, can we get it to that point underneath? I think we might. No! What? How does that interfere? Okay, well, it will be 9. So will this one. Then. But, and I accidentally did this while creating this area over here, where we want this one to extend out another 9. And go one down further even. And then line up underneath that. I think. No. Wait. No. It goes one further down even than that. The reason being is that I'm going to have a highway section that goes in between these. So these will extend through the center all the way to the remodeled over here once I get to it. But that this should go over this highway and this should go under, and then I can have off ramps that don't interfere with each other and this, that, or the other. So that traffic trying to get to the highways will go down one or the other of these. I forget which one I'm going to have do what, but actually, what if I made this a unique roundabout where all roads go to up here? It's a one-directional roundabout. This would be the weirdest kind of... It wouldn't be a roundabout anymore. Be a half roundabout. But anyways, people come out here, go down these streets. They would cross traffic on this side, though. That's what I want to try to avoid. Let's line them up, though. And put it one out. On this one. That is going to be one of the issues, is that it's going to want to jump between the two. But the best idea for this, and now that I have the depth, I can actually get rid of these. The best idea for this is to have an off ramp right here. But we need this to go down, is the problem. Actually, you know what? Let's have... Because this could interfere with the bottom one. That is the biggest problem here that I can see. Where's my lines? I can't see... I can't see my lines. I'm not getting any range gauges. Okay, so 1200 must be 5. Let's leave that going because I don't need it paused. 1200 must be 5. 24 must be 1. So, and I have an obsession with having it out by the exact amounts. That sounds right, because that's one in. That'd be right underneath that. Okay, you know what? Fine. We're just going to extend it, just like that. Let's get the angle down a little, because we need to grab this guy down here. And extend him out the same distance, just like that. Okay, now, we are going to want one of these going just up like this. And of course it's not going to like that because up like this. And then another one just from right there, very similarly, up like that. Now, here's where the big problem comes in, is that This one is so deep. It has to go down 1, 2, 3 to get to it. So, yeah. That's going to be really, really steep. So I'm thinking we just start kind of dropping it in general, because we need it to get under that, though. See, this is the biggest problem with this idea, is that it just goes too deep. It has to get too deep too quick. Come on. Can I go this way? Can I turn it? Yes. Maybe we just don't have a good angle. And because I don't have precision engineering, and this is an awkward angle. I can't get it straight. Well, I probably could, but it would take a lot of effort as well. And then down one more. Out to... can I just have it continuously going straight? And that is off a little bit, but... No, I want it to connect to the one down here. Distance is too short. That's fine, because that being straight doesn't help anyways. So we will have it curvy. We want it to come straight off of that and curve around. And then just... No. Maybe that wasn't enough of a curve. You know what? That is fine. That's how you get down there. I didn't actually plan out how all of these were going to work completely, so... But that works for now. We can refine the design as we continue on later. Anywho, continuing on, we have this drop down one. We have it drop down another right here. Let's have this one going outward a little bit, because we got that distance too short right there, and that's not going to help at all. And then we need this to connect up to that, preferably more at a 90-esque degree. And there we go. But that actually connects up this entire area with the road. So that's kind of our artery into this little section. We're going to have another one of these up here, down here, in the middle, over here. So there's going to be 8 outlet points to be able to get around. Now, the concept is that this will go all the way through. So if you're over here wanting to go over here, you can take this, which will cause a little bit of traffic, but the idea is, though, is if you're over here wanting to get up here, and that's where the spaghetti down here is going to have to be really orchestrated, is that you're going to have to, that it should be more effective just to drive around, that only directly across should be getting any extra traffic. Anywho, that being said, let's upgrade all of this, and it all should be pointing in the correct directions, so I don't think I have to worry too much about any of that. And then that one down there. So all of that's upgraded. I was pulling this in the opposite direction. Same with this, I believe. That all works because all the outlets are correct, right? That should be an in. This should be an out. Because the idea is you go out right here and turn in. You go out right here and turn in. You go in right here to get onto the highway. You go in right here to get onto the highway. Now, because of that little loop-de-loop thing is so long, I do worry that they might actually just try to go around to there, but we'll fix that when we come to that. So, let's get the highways all set up for this, because this is such a unique design. We'll actually extend this as far as we can that does not interfere with anything. And that's actually perfect, because that goes right over it. And we'll grab... the one down there. I want the one down. Down, please. Down, boy. There we go. And then this one should be just good to match. No, don't connect. I'm gonna have to get close again to line it up. And I believe that is even. So, right here, and this is helping a little, this little squigglies right here. We don't have any traffic backed up on this highway that much ever anymore, but we do have a lot of traffic kind of coming in here, so. And we'll have to think of doing something very similar up with Vanilla Coast, maybe a roundabout out here, making the middle of main road, roundabout up here, moving these around a little. So, just traffic has become such an issue, and it's obvious that I wasn't quite as good at doing any of this. We do have a massive, massive need for industry, and I have no clue why. We should... Well, we have a lot more industry area that we can build, so... Oh, did I not school? Why are there no elementary schools? Are these not... Those are high... That's why. Wah, wah. Okay, destroy. These are high schools. That's why we have no educated people over here. I know you're unhappy. Give me a second. I'm putting in the correct schools. We have no lower educated people around here. And that's what the problem is. Ooh, those elementary schools do not cover a lot. Well, that's an issue. Can we... get it up here, and then we'll have one down there. We're gonna have to destroy some of the structures up here to get it in if we're gonna do something like that. Yep, just like that. You move out the way. Move out the way. These are 1x2s. Oh, that's right, because the area is so small. Then we need a school right there. And we didn't even put anything up here, not even a high school. Me worrying about if there's college coverage when there's not even basic schooling coverage. And then we'll need one of those down there. And actually, we don't need any of this any further. It's all connected, so. And just get rid of it down to there, because we do still need that to connect across. And in fact, just so a lightning storm doesn't come by and go and give me the bird, we'll actually connect it right there as well, and right up here as well. Oh, wait. Yep, I can do that personally. Okay, and just like that. So that way the city has a lot of redundant connections. But yeah, that's why we were having issues, is that we just didn't have any elementary schools. That high school should be covering the entire area. It is. And then some. Okay. Let's get elementary schools. The highway side elementary. Oh, that's so terrible. Sorry, children. It's going to be noisy. Yeah, just right there, and just right there, and then we need a high school over here somewhere. One that preferably can cover the entire area. One side will cover better. Or it should cover better. It doesn't. Hmm. Which is weird because it usually is the way in that gets covered. Actually, over here does not get covered. So maybe two high schools out on the very edges for this one. A little closer up here to get the top of the zone up there. Yeah, just right there. And that means right here. There we go. That should have an effect on the population, but it's going to take time. We got to let people get old and die now, those that are uneducated, because if we look at schooling, graduated high. Wait, all of the people over here says are graduated.
Warning. Experts predict an earthquake could hit the area soon.
Oh no, right in the raspberry. They're gonna get raspberried. Well, that sucks. Me figuring out this whole epic layout for a highway to solve the problems over here, and they're gonna go and mess it all up. We do need... No one's really using this one, so we will just remove this one. This is gonna get removed anyways and replaced with this, so... there it goes. We don't exactly have any evacuation things, so... Ooh, that is really, really taking a toll on it. We still have an entrance over here, though, so we do have... Services can still get in to help out. A little pathway to the sea. Too bad we don't have rainfall. Otherwise, that might actually be effective. Okay, let's start repairing everything. That was main road, which would be this. But it was grassed. Grassed main road. And actually, let's upgrade just to fix all the roads. There, and there. Okay then, let's start getting some of these other roads connected now. And I'm not gonna fix the terrain. The terrain's gonna be however the terrain is, so. Be it that it destroys some of the, design, that's just... Well, we built around the earthquake kind of thing, so. Okay, that should all be reconnected. Get this park rebuilt. That should be all the traffic, though. That should be all the traffic. Get that rebuilt. Let's get a park in here. Just right there, and just right... Would that be one of these? Would that be a small one? That is three, so yeah, that would be a big one. Oh, that's right, because that road isn't, but this road is, so that needs that. No. You need to go somewhere else. Up there is fine. Three. And a two. And a four. A four. And a two. Oh dear, that's not very effective. Rebuild that. I can't put a park exactly where I want to on this. It jumps from one side to the other. So we are just going to have to build two of those right there. And just like that, the zoning here is going to be a little wonky, that's for sure. but the whole point is that we're not going to just blatantly fix it, are we? No, we're not going to blatantly fix it. We're going to live with the fact that there was an earthquake here and it destroyed a lot of the stuff. So, that would be 4. Just like that. A lot of that buildings will fix it anyways. When they come in. So, it's not necessarily as big of a problem as it would seem. And I think that's about it. We're just waiting on a lot of little parks and stuff like that to come back in. Or to be rebuilt, should I say? You know what? We'll zone it. Yeah, do that. we'll just throw the zoning back in. And they can build in however they want. I'm not gonna care too much. That actually is supposed to be bigger. I'm gonna get rid of these because that's supposed to be bigger. So that's bugging me that it is, and it's bugging me that it isn't. So, anyways, back to rezoning. Up there to down there. Up there to down there. And yeah, there's the houses back and everything. The terrain's a little wonky, but you know, after an earthquake, something's gonna be a little wonky. What's this? Oh, that's a residence. We have nothing else collapsed, and that is the last thing that required rebuilding. Or at least in the epicenter. We have a couple fallen stuff here and there that got fixed. Anything else? Nope. Okay. Back to the highway. And hopefully our industrial demand goes down here soon because I did get rid of the whatnots. And this just needs to be straight. It does not need to be any fancy. No, not on that road. The one below. Is that connecting to the one below? It is, but it's saying that it doesn't like it. Can I? Because if I pull it up, that's why this is so close to the surface. Oh, wait, we can have some. Just like that's fine as long as it does it. It doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to do it. A lot of people are using this though, and I don't like that. Okay, but anyways, the road down here, if we can get it somewhat similar. Is that down there? No, that's from that one again. Ah, right there. From right there. If we can... Yeah, that is coming up from that. Oh, too steep. Because it is coming up too. I don't like that coming off at a 90, though. Actually, you know what? Let's pause it real quick. We will get rid of the highway. We'll actually get rid of this off-ramp. Get rid of the highway rate. Oh, come on, seriously? Stupid trees are in the way. Through here. We'll leave that. We'll actually get rid of this center bit. All of the center bits, because we need this working. And though, yes, that means that there will be traffic, we're gonna fix it. Okay, and getting rid of everything up to there. Now then, I want you to, okay, that's surface, middle, okay, to drop to about right there, because you're gonna kind of fly through the gap, so to say. We'll do it at the 25, 52? Or the 2520. 1, 2. So right there. And connect. To 2552, down 2. The 2520. If I would ever say the correct value of this number, I had not said that correctly once until the end there. I do know this. I do realize it. Okay, now that is more precise. That is this highway going over this highway, which goes over this highway. So, at this point, we should be able to... That's a connection point up to this one. And it should be able to connect to these a lot nicer now. Just up like that. Where's the connection point here? It's way out there. Ooh, that's why I like making these segmented a little bit better. And up to there. But because of how we're designing this, it's not going to actually mess with it at all. Okay, we need the lower one. We need the lower, thank you. Oh, okay, so I need to put the cursor more on it, is what the problem is. Okay. I see the problem, and we'll fix it. Okay, up to there. And from down here, say right there. No, God. Seriously, game. I saw you. Me. Okay. Let's try to kind of have it even to right there. Okay, so that is connection one for this little area over here. I'm not sure how these areas are going to connect up to this because it's going to be a lot more square, but this is kind of how it's going to work at the moment. So, but I like it because it accurately deposits people over here, even though this turn is absolutely terrible. We do need to do something about that. Can we get rid of that for a second? Can we do the bendy road? Which direction is straight? It does not connect straight. Okay, there we go. Say there to there. That's a lot better. It's not great, but it's a lot better. It will at least have them come off the highway in a quicker manner than having to almost stop and make a UE. So that's a lot better. Now all we need to do is zone up over here to see if it works, which I would believe it would because of how this works. It's... bumping the mic. I am terribly sorry. Oh, and the timer went off a little bit ago. So that will be the end of the episode. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please do leave a like and tell me in the comment section below how you are liking this concept of the off-ramp. And we're going to have four of those, so another one over here, which will connect to these two lanes that are going across. We're going to have one up here and then another down here, which will have its own that goes through the center. They will drop mid-level, so two down, and go side by side right here through the middle and then kind of go back up into this vertical orientation afterwards. So that's how that's going to work. But yeah, in the comment section below, tell me how well you think this idea... is going to work, because I think it's going to work pretty well, because we're at this point not only depositing people in the middle of each quadrant, we might not even need the side ones right here, but we're depositing them on the side that they're going to want to go as well. So I just think that this might be a little too long, that this needs to be a little shorter, but we'll see if it works in the next one. Maybe. I'm not sure if we're going to be able to get any cars down here, actually, tell the truth. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one, and goodbye.